So, today it's time for Elliott Smith again. His fifth album I'm going to do in his discography. It's a second last one, so pretty exciting. What he got else after XO, which was a great album, I really loved that one. His other albums, all of them are such amazing singer-songwriter and folk albums. They are all so great. Last time I listened to Roman Candles, which was his first album, which was also a really interesting sight into his discography as he was moving to being a solo artist. And well, after that, he just came like to XO, which was his first album, as being in a major record label, which was pretty amazing to listen to and have a little bit of a different side on like his ideas and how he uses that opportunity of more more like budget or bigger budget, different instruments, and other interesting things he just like added to his style and ideas, and also like approaches into his sound and his songwriting also. Because the songwriting is a little bit more commercial, especially on Waltz number one, on the previous album. Like, there was also this one comment right there, which I read, which was like pretty interesting to that, where he just like was like, I'm really tired of stuff, and he was like performing he was performing Waltz number one, and I don't know, maybe there was something in the record label he didn't like. It was getting him tired or something like that. So it's really interesting. Maybe there will be a different sound on this album, or if he will be continuing with the same, we'll see. So let's see what this has to say. A lot. It's the fifth studio album, of course. Yeah. This was Elliott's final finished album before his death. Oh, damn. That's interesting. So the next album after that is After History. So it's kind of also a little bit sad to know that it's his last real album before his death. That's pretty hard, but we listened through it. It will be very interesting to see what kind of like sound he does on this one, or if he's trying something else. And it contains 16 songs, which are pretty much a lot, if you ask me, for an album. They are recorded from 1998 to 2000 at several locations, okay? Smith describes the songs on the album as more fragmented and dreamlike. That's pretty interesting. While XO was very different in style all over the album, so many different ideas, and so if it's like a main theme or like idea behind those album and tracks, that would be very interesting. So let's see. Let's just get right into it. The first track is called Son of Sam. So this is very alternative rock, kind of like 90s style, has a little bit at the beginning an easy listening style, and the worst one right there, is that about his career or something, because like something's happening, don't speak too soon, I told the boss off and made my move, got nowhere to go, something like that maybe, that would be very interesting in that kind of sense. I don't know who is the son of Sam is, or who Sam is, I don't know. A couple killer each and every time. I don't know. There is not an acoustic guitar, which is not happening pretty often in Elliott Smith tracks, of course, which is mainly his main instrument, but judging that is a certain, like, kind of like going into an alternative rock track right here or something like that. Obviously there's maybe not going to be many acoustic guitars right here. The only acoustic I could really like get off of this was a piano, like in the right kind of like center of the mix, which is pretty interesting. I like the mix. It's pretty much like very overwhelming at the beginning and just like throws all these instruments into your face with so many things going on, which is pretty interesting. And let's move on. The first track, this one is pretty interesting, very noisy, also with those guitar solo right there, very distorted, which is not really something common in Elliott Smith's discography, like working with many pedals or something, I guess. But yeah, it's very upbeat, very straightforward, also with those like pianos which just go nuts. It's a, like it's a, like, and it's also produced by the same people, I guess, as XO has. There were like three people mixing on this and producing, so that's pretty interesting. And really reminds me of like Japanese rock of the like also through albums. It's the like second part of this track right there, because it's a Japanese like rock and pop also kind of like scene. There's always like so much going on and so many instruments just blasting on your face, and kind of like also has a XO production style, of course, with those producers again. And I mean, it's catchy and a nice listen, so I don't judge anything right there. I think that as a first track, it's like very straightforward, like gets you into this album, like throws you in. So I'm kind of like feeling a 9 on this one. Pretty good, I like it. So let's move on to the second track, Somebody That I Used to Know. Is that maybe like the track? Which one? How is that called? I don't know. Maybe it's called the same. You know what I mean. Like this other track, which is pretty popular, which was like a 2000s track. Anyways, let's listen. Maybe it's something which has to do with that.
I had tender feelings that you made hard, but it's your heart, not mine, that's scarred. So when I go home, I'll be happy to go. You're just somebody that I used to know.
Then really nice trick right here. It's has acoustics. Very different from the first track right there, like something way different. It kind of like has his old production style from his first three albums, and also the typical Elliott Smith songwriting with like heartbreak and like ending relationships and stuff and past relationships. It's pretty typical that Elliott Smith has these kind of like things up his sleeve with his writing, so I like it. For that kind of like instrumental bridge right here was awesome. Sounds nice. I like it.
I know you don't think you did me wrong, and I can't stay this mad for long.
They also have like this radio kind of like lengths. These tracks are not really that long, as I see on this album right here. But yeah, it has a typical songwriting. It has a typical mixing also, and production style by Elliott, a little bit more lo-fi than something else. But yeah, I also really like those instrumentals like coming in there. Those are some great little like instrumentals going on with the acoustics. I really like that. But it has nothing to do though with the track I talked about. I think the track was called maybe something else. By Gotye or something. I don't know how he was called. I can't remember. But yeah, I still really like this track. This one is a nice little short track right there. So I like it. Feeling like a 9 on this one. Let's move on to the third track. Junk Bond Trader.
I
The harpsichord at the beginning right there of the track was really weird. So so overblown, like production style on this one, but I still kind of like some parts of it, like not the whole thing, but I like the songwriting, especially. It's really interesting, especially I really like this, like shaking into a small reality, boring as a drug you take too regularly, the athlete's love, the broken cross, the festering love that fought at the slightest touch. I like that. The second verse right there, interesting songwriting. Besides that, there's really nothing that's really like blowing me away or something. Happy holidays? Okay, that's like, where did that come from? But anyways. Really nice strings on this track. Sounds like very like expensive on this track right here, which also makes this kind of like pretty commercial, especially these chord progressions are pretty basic. Still like it though. I don't know why, but also like the voice of Elliott Smith is like, he kind of like doesn't have this like main part in these tracks with his voice, because I really like Elliott Smith's voice. But like this track, these tracks, which he made on XO, and right upon this album, especially, it's kind of like a side thing, just as a side dish, if you know what I mean. But yeah. Though I really love this part right here, where it's like with this like voice just coming out there, and then these perfect like little strings come in and swinging guitars with those perfect drumming right there. I really like that. I kind of like get the feeling of this songwriting like right here. Maybe he's talking about like stuff that's going on with like things that you don't really need and just buy it for profit, that you kind of like have this like sort of like better sell it while you can. So he's talking about something that he's not feeling like it's very important, or he's just thinking about this thing that going on with like making money off it. So it could be like several things right there, which is pretty interesting. And I really like the songwriting on this album so far, but it's Elliott Smith, of course. It's always like pretty interesting things going on right there. So yeah, so I'm feeling on this one like an 8. I really like this one. So let's move on to the fourth track, Everything Reminds Me of Her. Because I'm leaving. But everything reminds me of her this evening. Everything reminds me of her. Yeah, really nice instrumentals on this one. Nice vocals and nice kind of like licks in between with this guitar. It sounds amazing. Good sound design also with those electric guitars that come in sometimes in there with some like little kind of like jingle like kind of leaks, I don't know. The reverb on the vocals are kind of unnecessary, but I mean they are not like destroying this track. And the streamy thing Elliott sing, Elliott talk about in the description right there, really does apply to this track right here. So yeah, I like it. Everything reminds me of her. It also kind of reminds me of the last Roman Candle track that was an instrumental, which sounded like very nice. Kind of like gives me the feeling right here. Well, it is certainly different, like not that lo-fi as the Roman candle track, but I like this one. I think that this one is an 8, so pretty good so far. So let's move on to the fifth track, Everything Means Nothing to Me, after the previous track was called Everything Reminds Me of Her. That's interesting. So
someone found the future as a statue in a fountain. And attention looking backward in a pool of water. It means nothing to me.
Very dreamy. I like those pianos. They all sound amazing. Nice orchestration. Or would you call it awesome orchestration? No, not really. Orchestration is like a gathering of like instruments. So it kind of like, or just call this maybe songwriting. Or just like this melody. Those delayed drums came out of nowhere while I was like just sitting there like, well, this is pretty like pretty much the same and the same and the same, and then just like bam, and so strings and the interesting dreamy kind of like sound design coming in, really interesting. I mean, the songwriting is pretty obvious, Everything Means Nothing to Him, so yeah, really interesting. But the song itself is very good. Maybe I have to sync that track in, because I think that could be a pretty genius one. But yeah, so far I'm feeling a 9 on this one. Very good, very good. I like that one. So let's get to the next track, the 6th track, LA. The first one I don't really like that much as the other tracks, the weakest so far. The guitar sounds way too raunchy and distorted, and I don't know, it feels a little bit disconnected between the vocals, the drums and the guitars. But still, it has a vibe to it, and the singing by Elliott Smith is kind of like doing a pretty good job at getting this track into kind of like right feeling with the songwriting to that and the lyrics. So especially like with you, the generals are winning a war, seems to have a title before you came along, now it will check you along as you stay. I like that, and also like the songwriting so far, but it kind of like feels disconnected so far, but anyways. Well, the verse to the beginning, I really like this. If Patience started a band, I'd be your biggest fan. Look at me, I'm talking to you, I don't want the lead in your play. So Elliott Smith kind of like talks about like, he likes to give his tracks or like his songwriting maybe a little bit more of a space and thought, and kind of like let them sit, which is pretty, like Patience is very, very, necessary for good songwriting and stuff, because if you just like throw everything out you just like did, it won't be good. Because if you like keep on listening to your tracks that you made and the songwriting, you kind of like see the little dots that are not perfect or like needs a little bit of like polishment or something, and so right there the patience is very, it's very important. So it's kind of like interesting how Elliott writes about that. And after that he like wrote, look at me, I'm talking to you. So he's talking to someone, maybe his record label, who are not patient. I don't want the lead in your play. I don't want to be in your record label or in your band or something like that. Maybe he's like talking about his previous band he broke up with. So that's very interesting. It could mean those two things right there, or three things. Anyways, let's move on. Good songwriting. This snooze fest in the kind of like instrumentation production kind of like side, but still, because of the songwriting and it was that good, I'm feeling a 7 on that one. So let's move on to the 7th track, in the Lost and Found, Honky Back, or Honky Back, The Roost. What a title. But let's find out what this track got. Why honky tonk? What the hell is going on? This is strong. Well, this trick is interesting. Really weird, like idea of like forming maybe honky tonk and Bach or Bach, which is pretty weird. But anyways, the kind of like dream instrumentation coming in there with an accordion and like some deep strings, and yeah, kind of like a weird idea right here, and I don't know what to think about this right now. So now there comes like a second part right here as an instrumental. The first part is, I think, not that great, to be honest, but let's see what this instrumental is. Very weird track. Still really don't know that much what to think about that, but I'm feeling like something in between a 5 and a 6. Something right there. I don't know. Maybe it will change. You'll see. But anyways, let's move on to the 8th track, Stupidity Tries. And it'll come me down the side. Interesting track so far. Kind of like feels as a little bit like a mixture of the first track, some of them, and I think it was LA. It's like those distorted electric guitars coming in. Though I like Elliott Smith singing on this a little bit more. Songwriting is like not really that interesting to me right now. Maybe it will change, but there's like nothing really much for me right there at the moment, but let's move on. I couldn't think of a thing that I hope tomorrow brings. I also really like the effort on the production side, those instrumentals that, like Android, they sound amazing with those strings. They are so huge and grand and just like a big ultra right there that I really appreciate. But besides that, not really that much for me, to be honest. But yeah, I'm feeling like a 7 on that one. Although you've already disappeared within yourself, taking the easy way out for you, I suppose. This kind of like sounds like Elliott Smith 2.0. What's going on? This like kind of like songwriting and acoustic guitar structure ideas from the first three albums of him. Going out of the lofa into a more like clearer guitars right there, which sounds interesting but also pretty alien to me. While I absolutely love his first three albums, maybe because of that, but I kind of like have to get out of this headspace right there. But still, I like this track though. I mean, the songwriting is obvious, it's easy and structured on the main idea of like taking the easy way out of a person right here. And yeah, I mean, it's obvious. Yeah, I have not really much add to add. I'm feeling like between a 7 and an 8 on that one. Let's get to the train track, Wouldn't Mama Be Proud? He also has kind of like Sam Elliott Smith production right here as XO, with also Hammonds coming in, which was pretty often happening on the previous opening. So it sounds great, but kind of like the same structuring ideas on this one as XO really sounds weird with the combination of the dreamy idea of this album and the sound in that edition. So I don't know why, but yeah, let's move on. Production. It's interesting, nice instrumental choices. It really sounds great, but still the kind of like weird dreamy in background instrumentation right there is sometimes a little bit weird, but besides that, good track. I'm feeling an 8 on that one. So let's move on to the 11th track, Color Bars. The battles on the ground laying low again, high on the sound. Bruno. Everyone wants me to ride. Yeah, nice little short track right there. Pretty folky right off the bat. Also at the beginning a little bit more than at the end. But what is the content of the song right now? Like, I was reading along to this one and I couldn't really get much out of it. I don't know. But yeah, my also really nice dreamy strings at the end right there. Like, this production overall on this album like sounds even more expensive than on the previous album XO. So that's pretty interesting right there. But anyways, I'm feeling 7 to an 8 on this one. So let's move on to the next track, the 12th track, Happiness the Gondola Man. I really like also this line right here, while I remember to react in reverse to keep herself from herself, which kind of like means she always like knew what is going to happen next, or maybe she has a very nice, a good kind of like sense of what could be like a danger or something like that, and I really like that. It's a great line right there. The drums right there sound amazing, especially with them coming in at the beginning right there, and also a dreamy nice sound on this one. Has this really weird kind of like folk rock vibe to it that kind of reminds me of something that I can't really tip on my tongue right now. But anyways, good lyrics right here. Yeah, also like songwriting is pretty harsh on that one, especially from the first race, Activities, Kings, the Actor, Condo Cops, blah blah blah. And oh my, nothing else could have been done, made his life a lie, so he might never have to know anyone, made his life a lie, you know. That's brilliant, that's pretty hard, but yeah, I like this track. It's the longest track on this album so far, and in the like 2.5 minutes we are in right now, there's so much content and interesting sounds and things going on. I think this is a production totally top notch right here from their cut. That's my favorite track of this album so far. It has everything I want from an Elliott Smith track, plus the perfect dreamy sound and the XO kind of like vibe to it with this top-notch production right here. The drums are amazing, the ideas are pretty fresh on that one. So many nice things going on. Also, the little outro, the Gondola Man, as the second part of this one, was a perfect addition and a really interesting sound and ideas with those electric guitars playing that highly. It's a very good track. I'm fitting a 10 on that one. 10. Very good track. So, yeah. Let's move on to the 13th track, Pretty Mary Kay. Hallelujah, Pretty Mary Kay. I found faith in thee. Infirmary. There's a song. Very interesting instrumental choices right here. It sounds very gospel-like, with some like Rhodes and like organs on this one, and electric guitars that kind of like always are in the front, kind of like, which kind of like sound weird as addition onto this track, which is not really that necessary in my opinion. So something else needed right there, but I don't know why, to be honest. But the songwriting is not that interesting to me right here. It's like pretty easy written. Nothing that much, to be honest, but anyways. Ask everyone, have you seen a pretty Mary Kay? Have you seen a... So yeah, I don't really have that much to add to that track. I mean, it's a short track with kind of like the same thing going on right there. So I'm kind of like feeling a 6 to a 7 on that one. Let's move on to the 14th track, It Better Be Quiet Now.
Living alone probably be okay. It wouldn't be lonely. I got a long way to go. Carrying on, getting upset.
This one has an old Elliott Smith vibe. Pretty lo-fi. Nice, ready, smooth vocals right here. It's very silent. And kind of like the track title gave it away. Better be quiet now. And it's just it's like this quiet, very like soothing vibe. But it's not like the best if like Elliott Smith does these kind of like tracks. I think there are some better ones. Especially on his first album, Roman Candle, there are some really like smooth, slow, and really like dreamy, only acoustic tracks that are a little bit better than that one, but I still like it so.
Baby.
I really like this part, so had a dream as an army man with an order to just too much in my place while a dead enemy screams in my face. That's very picturey and it goes very like it's very hard like to listen to or just to read along with some texts like this while knowing this is his last time before his death, so it's pretty harsh, but anyways, let's move on.
But why you wanna do it this way? So I can't go the distance. I got a long way to go. I'm getting further away. I got a long way to go. I'm getting further away.
All right, with the track like moving on into the end, it kind of like ruined me. So I really like this track with this concept, just talking about like his he's just like tired of being tired actually. Also like, but I better be quiet now. I'm tired of wasting my breath, carrying on, not over it yet. Kind of like with that going on with that kind of vibe. So I really like that one. I'm feeling something between an 8 and a 9. So yeah, let's move on to the 15th track, so the second last track, Can't Make a Sound.
Can't make a sound, can't make a sound, can't make a sound. Nobody knows what the monologue means, nothing to me.
Really nice transition into those drums right there. I really like this beginning of this track. It sounds really good. I like the concept of this track also. Really nice.
Can't make a sound. Can't make a sound. Can't make a sound. Can't make a sound.
That's very good. I mean, this album really needed an outro like that. Like, that was amazing. I really love the orchestrations, the instrumentations, the choices of these strings at the end to get them in there like that and make the beginning of the track really like kind of like very reserved and slow, and gets this like huge grand explosion at the end. It's like very nice. And also in the kind of last seconds with the songwriting, kind of like really has a nice kind of like ending to this album. But let's see what the last track is. Like, I'm feeling between a 9 and a 10 on Can Make a Sound. But let's see what the real last track has. The 16th track, Bye. Last track as an instrumental is really haunting when you think about, like, this is the last track that got released before his death, and that's just very haunting, kind of like said, while it's like this track is called Bye. For that, I think that last track is perfect, feeling like 10. That one, that's an outro you should make. In that kind of sense, you, I mean, should I say should make, if it's like very literally meant in like the kind of like decision Elliott Smith made with this last track right there. But yeah, that was awesome right there. I really enjoyed that. So yeah, also this was his album. That was the last one. So yeah, really good album. I mean, it's a little bit different than all his other albums, but still being made by the same people that made XO in the production also. And I can see sometimes with this like dreamy thing Elliott Smith talked about in this like grand kind of scheme, but still it has pretty like similarities to XO. From also the feeling I have on this album. So yeah, I'm going to update you what I think about this album when I listen to it some more, right? So yeah, see ya. So yeah, Figure 8 by Elliott Smith is another great addition to his discography, his last one before his death. So yeah, this was the fifth album I did by Elliott Smith. And yeah, I mean, he's just a fucking great artist. I can't tell you anything else. I mean, if I have to take one album, I think would be on the like last place. It would be Figure 8 right here. But still, it's a great album. That doesn't mean that it's bad. There are like some tracks where I think that they are just like a little bit unnecessary or like skip able even to and if you just like take like 4 or 5 tracks out of this tracks track list, you will still have the perfect kind of like theme Elliott Smith wants to get along with, this like dreamy vibe, and like also as a last album before Steph, so kind of have a like that feeling. But I mean, how this album ends is just like amazing. Can Make a Sound and Bye are two like beautiful tracks, and also the 12th track right there, Happiness, was the first part right there, was amazing track.
I mean, there are some skips, but still great album, love it. I'm feeling a strong 7 to a light 8 on this album, so yeah. See you on the last Elliott Smith album, which is going to be From a Basement on a Hill. Is it? From a Basement on a Hill, right? From a Basement on the Hill, so yeah. It's the last album by Elliott Smith, the 6th album, the last one. Pretty excited about that one. See you.